All right, so good morning, everyone, after that fun little chat before, before class. So let's start by sitting really well in your particular pose. And you know, if you want just to change it up, you can always sit up on a block or sit in hero pose or anything like that. You're gonna wanna strap today. And go ahead and take a moment to put your strap in a nice big loop, nice big one. So there's just barely enough of the tail end of the strap to grab hold of. And then set that aside for now. So we're going to play with some, we're going to get back into the hips and the legs a bit. We're going to do a lot of really nice stretching, and I can't say enough about this stretching. I was just talking to a friend of mine whose low back was hurting and tried to walk her through by phone just some really easy stretches to release the tight muscles of the glutes, the low back, the legs, so that her low back would settle. So we're going to come into that, and then we're going to play with transitions today. So start by sitting really well and just check out where you're at this morning. Maybe take a nice deep breath, and as you exhale, just let it go, right? Let it all go. Let go of whatever else is happening in your world at the moment and come into the present moment. And maybe feel the back of your head lining up with the back of your sacrum, right? So that your head isn't reaching forward of your shoulders. And then feel both shoulders come to the side body, right? I always think of, if you bring the shoulders back without over squeezing, you should feel the engagement in the back muscles along the spine so that you know that the shoulders are starting to line up. And if you pictured your ears to your shoulders, they kind of line up, right? And then shoulders to hips as you sit. And notice if this alignment is challenging for you or if it's easy, right? So sometimes, especially if we're at a computer a lot, we start to develop this chest drop and the shoulder rounding. And before we know it, we're bringing that head forward and we're creating a pattern that we want to catch quickly. So start there. And then imagine someone can pull the crown of your head. I always think of like the flat spot of the head, and it's drawing that up toward the ceiling, and feel the back of your neck lengthen as you do that. Right, as if someone were just taking your whole head and pulling it up away from the neck a little bit without strain. And then feel the tailbone draw down to the earth. The low belly draws in towards spine and maybe lifts up a little bit. And we start to lengthen side body. Take your shoulders up to your ears. And wherever your hands are, just gently, like don't push down on your knees. Maybe you come up at your thighs. So shoulders up to your ears, push down at your thighs and imagine your side body getting longer, maybe even wiggle a little bit side to side. And then lift up as tall as you can, take the crown of the head up as high as it will go, lengthen the tailbone. And then just let the shoulders drop down, but keep the side body length and breathe. And notice where are your sit bones, right? If you are sitting cross-legged, where do you feel the sit bones? The sit bones are actually the very bottoms of the pelvic ring. And if you lean forward and back, you'll feel this little bony section that you can roll forward over, or you can roll back on, and that affects the low back, right? We are rounding or we're overarching. So see if you can find that. And as you close the eyes and as you're still playing with your breathing, as we keep tweaking the alignment a little bit, maybe you find just a marvelous sense of wonder at your body. If we think about our age and we think about all we've been through, and then we think that these bodies are still upright, that's a whole lot of gratitude happening there. And then open the eyes if they are still closed. Take the hands out to your sides. Inhale, reach up. Let your hands come together. Release them down to your heart. Keep the wrists touching. So keep the palms of the hands, not the wrists, the palms of the hands touching. And then press down as low as those hands will go without the palms separating. Good. And then inhale up. Exhale, open. Exhale it all the way down. Good. Inhale it up. Take those hands together. Press the palms together. Draw those hands down low. Don't let the chest collapse. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, open and let it go. Good. One more here. Inhale it up. Exhale, press down. Good. Inhale up. Exhale, open it and let go. Good. And then straighten those legs. And shake them out, move the flesh out from your sit bones, grab your strap. Now I want you to take the strap around your body, down to your sacrum, right? So I think you all know this by now, but maybe not. I don't wanna assume. So right, here's your lower back, right? So everybody put their hands on their low back and feel it, right? It's above the line of the hips. And if you put your hands on your hips, you can feel the lower rim of the lower back muscles, right? And so then below that is where your sacrum starts, right? Sacrum and then your tailbone, right? When we used to have tails. So I want that strap around your sacrum. Round your sacrum. And then place your left foot in the strap. It's still around your sacrum. You might have to, if I didn't do that, but you might have to have that strap, the tail of that strap around the outside so that you can adjust it once you're there. So feel the strap around your sacrum. I think you got it, right? And then tighten the strap around your left foot, bring your right leg, your right sole of your foot to your inside left thigh. Maybe a block goes underneath your knee. So we're in Janu Sirsasana, right? I call it a single leg forward fold. And I want that strap to be tight enough that you feel it around your sacrum, drawing the sacrum forward as you feel it around the foot, and then push your foot away from you and feel how tall your torso gets. And so again, crown of the head lifts up, the tailbone lifts down, and feel the connection here, right? Foot to hip, that nice long thigh, everything working. Inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, partway down. Excuse me, don't let go of the pressure on your strap. I'm actively pressing my foot into the strap and then just let your hands come forward. If you feel like your strap's gonna slip, just lower it down a little bit more, lower it on the sacrum a little bit more. And then find this connection between the ball of the foot and the sacrum. As you press into the sacrum, press into the foot, resist a little bit and breathe. Maybe you come down closer to the leg, but don't round forward. Keep the torso nice and long. Keep the crown of the head reaching up. Find your breath. Breathe. Some of you might be able to put your left hand on your foot. If not, maybe your left hand is just holding onto the side of your strap. And then twist your torso to the right. And maybe take the right arm up. Easy here, mindful here. resist the strap, pressing your foot into the strap, pressing your sacrum into the strap. Find your breath and release. Maybe both hands go to your strap or both hands go to your foot. Keep the shoulders wide, right? Don't round all forward or take your shoulders up to your ears. Keep the shoulders wide. And then keep the pressure on the strap and push back, push back, push back. Lean back and feel that anterior tilt of your pelvis. Good. And release. So you're simply gonna switch sides. So take the strap in your right foot. Now, don't assume that the length is gonna be the same for you. This side might be tighter and therefore the strap is gonna need to loosen up a little bit. So once again, come into Janu. Imagine that your right foot is stepping on the floor, right? So it's nice and flexed. You've got lots of pressure there. And then imagine the engagement of your whole right leg if you were stepping on the floor, say doing tree pose, right? So breathe and just notice that. We forget sometimes to make the connection from the leg to the hip, finding our breath here. And then inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, start to take the torso forward. Again, I have to lower my strap just a little so it doesn't round up to my low back. Let the hands come down. Keep the pressure both on the sacrum and on the foot. So I'm pushing back with my sacrum. I'm pushing forward with my foot. Keeping my shoulders nice and wide. Stretching out that hamstring, right? And then maybe the right hand goes to your foot. Maybe the right hand just holds on to one of those sides of your strap. Open up the left chest, left shoulder. Maybe take the left arm up. So coming into a twist, go easy. Twists early in class are always a softer twist, at least for me. Big deep breath. Open up that side of your body. And then release the left hand. Place both hands on your foot or both hands holding on to your strap at any level. Keep pushing that foot into your strap. Keep pushing back. Resist it with your sacrum. That's it. And release it. Good. And then keep the strap around your waist and shimmy yourself so that you're laying on your back. So that strap is still underneath your sacrum. You might have to just keep some tension on it. Take the strap around your right foot and take that leg up to the ceiling. Keep your left leg bent for now. Once again, you're gonna adjust. You're feeling this, but this time I want you to take that strap that's around your right foot and bring it to your right heel. So less on the ball mound, more on the heel. And again, feel the connection between your heel and your hip. Now the strap is tight, right? So that we really have to resist. So I'm pressing down with my sacrum. I'm pressing up with my foot and I'm just relaxing my upper body. Now, if this is way too much for you, then loosen up the strap and let the leg lower a little bit. If this feels good, this feels like an awesome stretch, straighten your left leg to the floor. And then overarch your spine. I don't know if you can see on the computer, but overarch your spine so that your left leg goes flatter to the floor, and then draw the belly in. So the leg might not be quite as high, maybe it's more 90 degrees instead of closer to the face, but the lower back is back to neutral. The left leg is grounded, the right leg is getting a gorgeous stretch, your upper body's relaxed, maybe the upper body goes to cactus pose. That's it, big deep breath. Good, relax your right knee, listen up. Now let's just switch. So bring your left foot in, bring it the strap to the heel, put your right foot on the floor to start. You might have to adjust your strap. And feel that, shoulders are down, belly is toned. Push into the strap, resist with your hip. Straighten the right leg if it makes sense for you. Arch your low back so that your right leg goes closer to the floor. And then draw the belly in, draw the ribs back in. And push, relax your upper body. Shoulders are to the floor. They're nice and soft. Your jaw soft. You're just checking this out. This is such a sweet hamstring stretch for most people. We just kind of fall into it and let the strap do the work so that we're not holding on to anything. Big deep breath. Good. And then bend your knee. Release your leg from your strap. Take that strap and make it a little longer again. And then walk the strap up your back. Walk it up your back. These are always fun to teach in Zoom. And take it off your left shoulder and wrap it around your right shoulder. So I have that strap around my right shoulder. I still have this big old loop. I'm going to put my right foot in the strap. You're going to want that strap where you can adjust it. So once your leg is up there, it's around your right shoulder, around your right foot. It's tight enough that it'll stay in place. Straighten your left leg. Now peel your right shoulder into the floor, not peel, but drop it in and keep it there and take your right leg across to the left. It's not going to go as far as you would maybe do normally if you were just holding your strap. By the way, if your strap's not long enough for this, don't worry about the loop. Just put it around your foot, but try to keep the right shoulder down. Now, if you are like almost everybody I know, pretty much everybody I know, you're going to feel this stretch all along the right hip. Maybe down to your right knee, maybe into the right outer shin. That is perfectly normal. Try to keep your right leg pretty straight. Don't hyperextend it. And take a really deep breath into this. That's it. And each exhale, right? Each exhale, maybe we get a little bit of a release of those hips. You want to talk about, right, as we sit and sit and sit and sit, what are we doing to these poor little muscles on all along the glutes? So here we are just stretching this baby out. Take a deep breath and then take the right foot up, but keep it there. Release the strap from your right shoulder and throw it over your left shoulder and then press the left shoulder to the floor to keep that strap in place. You may or may not want to loosen your strap a little bit. That strap's going to the outside, the right side outside. Just watch that that strap isn't hurting any of your breast tissue or, along the neck. Adjust it as you need to. You can even use your hand to keep it away from your neck if it's bothering you. And let that leg reach out to the side. Once again, I'm pushing my foot into the strap, but I'm seriously resisting with my left shoulder. And then try to relax into it. Good. Really ground the left leg. Really breathe here. I know some of you in class today have been traveling, right? And whether you've traveled by plane or by car, your legs, your hips, your back, it just takes a toll. So let's let all that go. All right, I could stay here forever, but let's take that leg back up. Hold on to the strap. Take your left foot and put the left foot in. Take your right foot out. Extend again. You may or may not want to tighten up that strap. Keep it around your left shoulder and take your left leg across. Straighten your right. Ooh. I don't know about you. Maybe it's all the hiking I've been doing, but holy moly, is that a wicked little stretch, a nice little stretch, but it's, it's intense. And I like using the strap for these because I can let go. I can just relax my upper body I can let go of the strain there, let go of any neck tension, and just let the stretch happen. Little tone to the belly, not a lot, but just enough, right? Feel that big old stretch on your hip. Take one more deep breath. Take the leg back to center, just switch shoulders. Take the strap around your right shoulder and take your left leg out to the left. This is another one, right? You could go deep, you could go a little. How tight are your inner hams or your inner thighs? How tight are they? Can you breathe here? And there is value in not going to your deepest level because there are all kinds of stretches happening that you may miss if you just go super deep. And your cue here is the right shoulder. If your right shoulder is off the floor, you're too far, you're too deep. So tighten it up. Take a really deep breath. Let it all go. Good, one more here. Exhale, let it go. Take that leg back to center. Take both feet in your strap. Release the strap from your shoulder. Reach the arms up and hold on to that strap. Good. I want you to slowly lower the legs, but keep a bunch of tension on that strap and see if you can get it to sit you upright. And then let go of your strap. Great fun there. And once you're there, shake it all out, everybody. Come right up to table pose. Now, if your wrists are challenged today, come on down to your elbows. Otherwise, you're on your hands. Take your hands nice and wide. Spread your fingers. Grab hold of that beach ball we're always talking about between the elbows and press your right leg back. Tone the belly in and lengthen your torso, right? What did we do to lengthen the torso? Crown goes one way, tailbone the other way, right? The armpits nice and deep, and then lift your right leg off the floor. And I want you to imagine that you're going to bring your knee through water. So it's a little bit, it's very fluid, but very soft. And as you bring that knee in toward your chest, I want you to tuck your head. Keep your knee bent and lift that knee away from the floor as you look up. So variation here. Good. Squeeze it in, tuck your chin, and then reach it up. Keep the knee bent as if you could press your foot to the ceiling. And three more. Bring it in. Inhale as you lift. And two more. Keep the knee bent. Lift up from your glute. And last one here. And lift up. And once that knee is lifted up, I want you to turn it out to the side. And then straighten the leg. Woo! And then bend the knee and drop it down. Lift it up 90 degrees best you can. Straighten it out the best you can. Bend it and lower. One more here. Lift, straighten, bend, and lower. Good. And shake out those wrists if they need it. Let's go to the other side. Press your left leg back. Squeeze the belly in. Open up your shoulders. Lift your leg. When you're ready, slowly through water, you're just squeezing it in. Keep the knee bent as you lift it up. If any of you have a pool, right, or access to water, I'll tell you, it's so good for the joints. Squeeze the knee in, keep the knee bent as you squeeze your butt, lift that knee. Two more. And lift. Whoops, almost straightened my leg there. Last one, bring it in, and then lift it up. From that lifted position, take it out to the side. Woo, straighten it out. Woo, and bend and lower to your other knee. Good. Reach it out to the side. Press it out. Bend the knee and lower. One more here. Lift, press, bend, and lower. Good. Walk those wrists forward. Stretch out the wrists here. Stretch out your shoulders, arms. And breathe. Good. We're going to go back to the right side. Plant the hands. Remember, you can come to elbows here. Press your right leg back. Tone the belly in. Lift the leg. Bring it into your chin. Keep it bent. Lift it up. Turn it out to the side. Straighten the leg. Good. Lower it down to the floor. Walk yourself up. Find gate pose. So in gate pose, your left knee, left hip are lined up. Your right foot that you may not be able to see on me is pressing into the earth. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, let your right hand come down toward your knee or below or above. Stretch out your whole left side. That's it. Big deep breath, everybody. And then inhale, both arms up. Exhale, hands to the floor. See if you can squeeze that belly in. Lift your leg up. Take it back. Bend your knee and let it go. I'm going to turn around, do the hokey pokey. Left leg out. When you're ready, lift. Squeeze in through your belly. Draw your knee to your chin. Keep it bent. Lift it up and squeeze that butt. Turn the knee out to the side. Stretch it out. Woo, good. Lower it to the floor. Plant your left foot. Lift all the way up. Inhale, take it up. Exhale, slide the left hand down as the right arm reaches over. And breathe. This is never about how far down you can go, right? It's how does it feel as you stretch that right side. Inhale, both arms up. Exhale, both hands to the floor. Squeeze your belly in, lift that leg, take it back, whoo, and let go. Let's do that again. Right leg back, lift up, squeeze your belly, knee to chin, chin to knee, reach it up, turn the knee out, reach the leg out, whoo, drop that right foot. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, right hand down. Left arm over. Big side body stretch here, everybody. Inhale, both up. Exhale, hands come to the floor. See if you can lift that leg. Whew, take it back and lower that knee. Are y'all having fun seeing me go back and forth here? And left leg out. Last one. Squeeze the belly in, lift the leg. Feel your butt, by the way, right? Breathe, bend your knee, bring your chin to your knee and reach it up, squeeze. Take the knee out to the side, straighten that leg out, lower that foot to the floor. Check your alignment as you take those arms up. Exhale, lower that left hand down the left leg. It's barely touching, everything squeezing into the center. And inhale up, exhale, hands come down. Good, lift your left leg, swing it back. Lower your knee to the floor. Take both hands to the front of your mat. Squeeze that belly in, downward facing dog. Once you're there, pedal out. Stretch it out, pedal those feet. Broaden through the shoulders, those upper arms externally rotating. The fingers clawing into the mat a little bit. And breathe. Tippy toes. And exhale, heels. Good. One more. Come up to your tippy toes. Exhale, the heels closer to the floor. Breathe. And then walk those hands all the way back to your feet. Bend the knees a whole bunch, everybody. Hands to knees and come on up. Woo, shake it out. Shake, shake, shake. All right, so I want you to grab your blocks and place them at the front of your mat. We're going to play with a little bit of transition work, and you'll see why, because we tend to do the same things over and over, and we might not think about what it takes to get from point A to point B. So take the blocks to the front of your mat, both blocks are up high, and walk the feet back just enough so that you feel pretty much like your hip bone and your ankle bone are lined up. And then take your hands to your blocks, widen through the shoulders. It's a nice neutral spine, I'm not rounding. If you have room to move here, you can bend the elbows. Think about the crown of the head lengthening to that front edge of your yoga mat, right? Tailbone drops down. What happens to the belly? It draws in, right? And then feel as you draw the belly in, how that lengthens your whole spine. And pause for a moment. The elbows are facing each other, or they're not swinging out to the sides, right? They're staying alongside your torso. The spine is getting longer. Imagine someone said that you could pull the crown of the head toward the floor. Just making it a little bit longer. The knees are soft. Good. And then press it, your hands into your blocks to come halfway up. Head is neutral. I'm looking down at the floor. I want you to bend both knees a little bit. And then just peel your right foot, your right heel off the floor. Just peel it, right? Ball mound is still down. And what did that take? Maybe do that a couple of times. Just lift and lower, right? Calf muscle is engaging as you lift. And then hold that lift. Here's where it gets a little trickier. Squeeze the belly in and take your right foot off the floor, just a couple of inches. What does that require? And then see if you can straighten your left leg, right? So that left knee was bent. It straightens. The right foot is lifting off the floor. Maybe you can bring that knee close to chest. Woo! And then lower the ball mound of your right foot, lower your heel. Bend both knees, inhale, reach up. Exhale your hands to your heart. Sometimes, and if you need to come out of that forward fold sooner, just go ahead and do it. Sometimes all that blood rushing to the head can be a bit much, right? All right, so hands back down. Your hands are pretty light. The belly is toned in. The spine is long. Peel your left heel and maybe do that a couple times. Feel the calf muscles, right? Another really important muscle in our balance work. And then lift the heel and hold. Squeeze the belly. See if you can lift your left foot off the floor, even if you lift it a half inch, right? And then see if the left knee will come up toward your chest. This is getting a whole bunch harder. The core has to squeeze in, and then lower the ball mound and lower the heel. Bend both knees. Inhale, reach up. Exhale your hands to your heart. Release. Let's move on. Inhale, take it up. Exhale your hands to your blocks. Everything widens, right? Everything engages. The inner thighs work toward each other. Peel your right heel. Peel your right foot. See if that right knee will come closer to the chest. Keep that bend in your knee and lift that knee up as if you could step your foot on the ceiling, right? We did this when we were down on our hands and knees. And then bring your knee to your chest and lower the ball mount. Lower the heel, left side, lift the heel. Lift the foot, squeeze that leg in, bring the heel back, keep the knee bent, lift, 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 squeeze your butt, bring it all the way back, lower the ball mound, lower the heel, inhale, reach up, exhale your hands to your heart, pause for a moment, shake it out. Good. See where this is maybe going? Maybe. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, your hands to your blocks. Widen through your shoulders. Squeeze your belly. Peel your right heel. Peel your right foot. Squeeze your knee up. Bring the knee back and extend through your thigh. and then straighten the leg if you can. I know, right? So here we are in a precursor to warrior three. Good, bend your knee. Bring the knee back into your chest. Whew. Straighten the leg, ball mound, heel. Bend both knees, inhale, reach up. Exhale your hands to your heart. If you start to feel it all dizzy from all the head down stuff, just pause a little longer in your standing pose. All right, other side, lift up. Exhale, come on down. Peel your left heel. Peel your left ball mound. Bring your knee to your chest. Keep the knee bent and reach that thigh back. Squeeze your belly. Straighten your leg. Hold. Woo. Bend your knee. Bring the knee back to chest. Lower the ball mound. Lower the heel. Bend your knees. Inhale, reach up. Exhale. We have one more here. Maybe try taking your blocks to second level. They're just a little bit more stable. If you can't, if that's not happening, you can't lift or reach, go to higher level. Just be a little cautious with the step back, okay? Inhale, reach up. Exhale, come on down, pause. Here we are in our forward fold. What do you do in your forward fold, right? So for me, I feel my sit bones lift up. I feel the inner thighs get a little bit wider. My feet are equally weighted front to back. My spine is long. My shoulders draw away from the ears. My belly is, of course, toned. All right, lift your right heel. With the blocks lower, it'll be a little bit harder to get that lift. Lift your foot off the floor. Bring your knee to your chest. Keep that knee bent. Slide the knee back. Straighten the leg. Good, listen up. I want you to bend your left knee and slowly drop your right foot to the floor so that you are in a lunge. Adjust your blocks if you need to. Squeeze your belly. Start to lift your chest. Come to fingertips. Squeeze your belly. Press into your front heel. Do a little tiny cat, like a little rounding of your low back by squeezing the belly button more. And inhale, slow, slow, slow. Lift up. Woo. Talk about transitions, right? And then exhale, slow. Back to your blocks. Woo. Here we go. Blocks maybe move forward. I want you to push slowly off your back leg. It goes back to straight. Bend your knee. Bring your knee to chest. Slowly lower ball mound and heel. Bend both knees. Come on up. Exhale your hands to your heart. Shake it out. Breathe for a moment. There is such a difference between zoom, 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 right? Going fast, going fast, going fast. We don't even think about it. And going slow, right? Painfully, deliciously, awesomely, slow. Good. So breathe, everybody. Here we go. Left side. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Keep the shoulders wide. Engage those side back muscles. Peel your left foot. Peel your left ball mound. Squeeze that knee up as high as you can. Reach the thigh back. Straighten the leg. Bend your front knee to slowly lower your back foot to the floor. Maybe the blocks move back just a little bit. Shoulders stay really wide. Squeeze your belly and do a teeny little cat. Right, I'm just squeezing into the center to engage all those muscles and then come to your fingertips, press through those feet, lift the arms up, right? Nice high lunge here, stretching through the front of the body. Exhale, little tiny cat as we release those hands down. Maybe walk the blocks forward a little bit. as you transition, you're weighting that front leg, you're peeling your back leg. Lift up, bend the knee, bring your knee to your chest. Slowly lower the ball mound of that foot, the heel of that foot. Bend your knees and inhale, reach up. Exhale your hands to your heart. Good, shake it out, everybody. And just turn sideways on your mat. We'll transition just for a minute here. Big, deep hinge of your hips. Let's come on down, nice forward fold. Allow your hands to be on the floor and draw the elbows back toward the center line so that if you bent your elbows, they would be back behind you. And then with your hands, I want you to isometrically pull your hands, push your hands away from you, okay? So just push them away as if you kept going, you would lean back, but you're resisting. Find your breath. Good, heel toe those feet in a little bit. Bend your knees, stick your butts way back, way, 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 way back. Take hands to both knees and come on up. Good, bring the legs together and shake them out. All right, I want you to set your blocks just to the front of your mat. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, bend your knees as much as you need to. Hands or fingertips come to the floor. Open up those shoulders. Bend the knees, peel your right hip or your right heel. Peel your right foot even harder. Bring that knee as high as you can. Reach it back, straighten the leg, bend your front leg, land your right leg. Maybe you have to widen a little bit. Walk the hands back, little baby cow or cat pose. Squeeze the belly in. Start to lift your chest. Take the arms up. And breathe. You got this. Good. You're in this nice high lunge. Maybe the arms come to cactus pose, right? How wide can you make the elbows, keeping them at the side body? Big deep breath. Maybe those hands come behind you to interlace. And breathe as the chest opens up, right? Take a deep breath here. And then release those hands, reach them up. Start to transition forward. What happens, right? Right away, you start to go to the ball mound of your back foot. Those hands come back to the floor. How do you get from here to that lift of the leg? I've got to squeeze my belly in, weight the front foot, peel the back leg, straighten the front foot. Holy moly, bend the knee. Bring your knee to your chest. Try to step it forward. Land that foot. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, your hands to your heart. I know, right? Who would think something so simple can be that much more challenging just by slowing it down a little bit? Maybe it's not for you. Maybe it's just challenging for me. All right, here we go. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, take it down. Open up the shoulders, squeeze your belly, lift your left ball or heel, lift your left foot. Bring that knee toward your chest. Keep the knee bent as you lift, right? Even that, so much work. And then straighten the leg. Both legs are relatively straight. Bend your front leg or front knee. Start to land. And breathe, maybe widen a little bit, right? Widen your stance. Squeeze the belly in, hands, chest lift. Take it up. Oh, right? Maybe cactus pose. Maybe arms reach back and behind and you open up the chest. Oh, that feels so good, right? Good, release. Reach the arms up. Little cat-ish pose, right? As we start to round forward, hands come to the floor. I've got to lean over that front leg, peel the back foot off, lift it up. Oh, bend the knee, knee to chest, foot to the floor. Bend both knees. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, let it go. Good. Roll out your shoulders. Roll out your hips. Oh. Beautiful, beautiful. All right, so come on to the front of your mat. Your blocks are there if you would like them or if you need them, right? So what does all that mean? What did we just do and why? As we start to put the pieces together, start with your hands at your heart. Feel the back of the head line up with the back of your shoulders or back of your sacrum, right where we started seated. Your shoulders are at your side body. And if you lined up your ears and your shoulders, they would line up. And notice when you snug in the belly, not so much that you can't breathe. You should be able to take a nice full breath. But as you tone that in, what happens to the low back? It got longer, right? So breathe. Take the tension out of your neck, your head, your shoulders, especially the jaw muscles. All right, inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. If you would like your blocks, take them at the lowest level. Bend your knees, right heel, right foot, knee to chest, reach it back. We've done this a zillion times now. Bend your front knee and slowly land your back foot. Squeeze the belly in, hands come close to body as you reach up. That's it, find your breath. Bring both hands back down, take your right hand to your knee and take your left hand to your sacrum and draw the left elbow, left shoulder back. Squeeze your back glute. Find your breath. Good. Inhale it back to center. Exhale, hands to your blocks. Maybe walk the blocks up about a half of a foot. Reach into your hands, your blocks. Lift your right leg. Lengthen your chest. Maybe reach your left arm back. And breathe. So left leg standing, left arm reaches back, belly squeezes in. Bend your left knee, land your right foot, plant that those hands, and then push back up. Bring the knee, bring the foot. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Soften your knees. Step back, lift your left heel. Left foot, left knee, reach it back, extend it out. Bend your right knee to land your left foot. Find your pose. Your blocks are under your hands, under your shoulders. Squeeze. Bring your hands close to your chest. Lift up. Find your breath. Notice. Left hand to knee, right hand to sacrum. Press through your back leg. Find your breath. You got this. Inhale, center. Exhale, hands to your blocks. Maybe walk those blocks forward just a little. Start to lean into your front foot. Lift your back leg. Fire up your belly, your glutes. Let the right arm reach back as well. Yep, you got this. Find your breath. Whew. Good, release. Just simply bend your right or your left knee and land that foot. And inhale, reach up. And exhale, shake it out. Good, go wide on your mat. Big hinge from your hips, come on down. Maybe the arms walk forward. Right, push your hands away from you, widen and lengthen your torso. And notice, right, if you just kind of let your belly hang, it feels okay, right? But then draw the belly in and up, up meaning up toward the ribs, not so much that you can't breathe, but enough so that the lower back just got longer And then resist with the hands as you lean back with the sacrum. And feel how long your torso can get. Keep the legs active, by the way. Notice your breath. Deep breath. It's like being in traction, right? So we are stretching from our sit bones to our shoulders, really even up to the fingertips. And we're creating this length in the spine. We're juicing up all those vertebrae, all those discs between the vertebrae. Good, soften your knees, everybody. Big soft knees. Walk the hands back, lift up, heel toe in enough. Bend your knees, hands to knees. Come on up. Good, roll it out, like really roll it out. I taught a class one time and it was after being somewhere, I can't remember where, we were in some town and we were watching this man who was kind of a contortionist. And I found it amazing. So I want you to come to the front of your mat and I'll just describe it as we do so. What he did was he came into a forward fold. And when he first came into the forward fold, it was like he could barely touch the floor. So I want you to start by coming into a forward fold. Backs of the knees are soft, but the legs are straight. And just imagine that you can't get anywhere near the floor. So tone the belly in and lengthen your whole spine. And then start to wiggle. It almost felt to me like I was wiggling like the sweetest, friendliest snake. So if you're afraid of snakes, pick something else. And I just started to go, where is the space in my ribs, right? What's holding my torso tight, right? This whole gravity thing. And so then I got a little bit more centered, lower your blocks one and see, keep wiggling here and imagine that you are creating space from your hip to your armpit, right? Where is the tightness for you? Your belly is toned the whole time. You should have no irritation in your lower back. And then maybe you get rid of your blocks and your fingertips come to the floor. And where else is there space? Maybe the arms have to come more forward. Maybe you have to lean into these side hips, right, that we were stretching. Maybe that's where it is. And as you keep wiggling and keep wiggling, watch low backs here, right? So this is mindful, mindful, mindful. If your low back is super unhappy, you come back to those blocks and you wiggle more neutral spine. Soft back of the knees, and then come to stillness wherever you choose. And I want you to breathe into the back of your legs, the back of your sit bones, your lower back, your side body, right? And then bend your knees. Whew. Start to lift your head and torso. Hands come to knees and press all the way up. Right? And just feel it. Just feel it. Like all of this, right? All of this. All of this. Just feel it. All right. So, final thing here, and then we'll take it back down a little bit. Have your blocks nearby. Here's what I would like for you to do. And you're not gonna need your blocks unless you want them just to have them there. The other option is to be near a wall space so that you can work on balance near a wall. So you're at the front of your mat. And I want you to take a small purposeful step with back with your right foot. So maybe you lift the heel, maybe you lift the foot, and then maybe you step back. Not a big step, right? So we've been doing this all class. Your hips are forward, your shoulders are forward. And then you're gonna kind of look in the distance a little bit, right? It's called our dristi, or our focus point. As you weight your front foot, I want you to feel that squeeze of the belly, the chest stays lifted, the hands stay on your hips, and see if you can lift that leg. Once you lift the leg, reach the arms back. Airplane pose. Big deep breath. Yep. And then bend your left leg. Land your toes back. Inhale the arms up. Hands to hips. Step forward. And breathe. Same thing, other side. Peel your left heel, peel your left foot, right? Already I'm starting to kind of get my core engaged here. Reach the leg back and step it back. Your front knee is bent. I like coming into airplane this way because it's almost like you're taking off, right? You weight your front foot, squeeze the belly, open the shoulders. Maybe you lift, maybe not. Maybe your big toe is on the floor. Once you're here, maybe you reach the arms back and breathe. Maybe you've got one hand on a wall, right? Or someplace, chair. Woo, hands to hips, bend your front knee, step back, inhale up. Good, hands to hips, push off. And step forward. Good. And then from the front of your mat, inhale up. Exhale, come on down. Step all the way back to downward facing dog. All the way back. And feel your torso. Feel the length of your body. Press into the thumb and index side of your hands. Breathe. You got it. And then lower your knees. Take the knees wide on your mat. Release your feet and come to child's pose. And in child's pose, let your hands stack to make a rest for your head. And breathe. That's it. All right. Grab one block and your strap. Come on down to your mat. You're going to be on your back. So you got your strap and your block nearby. Come on to your backs. Your knees are bent. And I just want you to do a few pelvic tucks and tilts here. Yep, just soften it all down. And then grab your block at the lowest setting and put it underneath your sacrum, right? If your hands are on your hips, remember that. The block is below your hands, below your hips, below the top rims of your pelvis. So not in your low back. And then grab your strap and place it around the front of your ankles and let your feet come back to the floor. Don't worry about the loop, no loop. You don't need a loop. And give your strap a little bit of a tug. In other words, walk your hands down your strap and then press the backs of your arms into your strap. So we're in bridge pose, right? But there's a resistance here with your shins or with your ankles. as you press down, and then optionally lift your hips off your block. There should be no pain or strain in your head or your neck. Your shoulders are planted down to the floor. You're reaching with your straps, you're pressing the backs of your arms into the floor. Your knees are staying parallel to each other. Your feet are pressing into the floor. And then lower your hips back down. Release your strap, set it aside. Your feet come to the floor. If your knees allow, your fingertips brush your heels. Your arms go to cactus pose. And right away, I want you to feel the lift of your chest, like poof, right? As if somebody put a beach ball underneath your shoulder blades and it's pressing it up toward the ceiling. So feel that, right? There's a bit of an arch here in the low back that you need to be mindful for. So what are we gonna do to help with that arch, right? Our chest is big time lifted. So I'm gonna squeeze the belly in and then press into my feet. Maybe the arms go just on the floor, but overhead so that the shoulders are completely relaxed. Push your feet into the floor, press your shins forward, release the hands to your sides. Maybe walk those upper arms under and press and lift into bridge pose. Breathe. It's as if someone had a hold of your shins and is pulling the shins forward at the same time all this is working. And lower down, everybody. Stay on your block. Fix your block if you got a little bit out of the way. Bring your left knee to your chest and straighten your right leg down to the floor. Just breathe. If that's hard on the knee, just reach underneath. Shoulders, head are relaxed. Your right leg is pretty relaxed here. We're stretching the front psoas muscles. And just breathe. Good, and then squeeze your belly, slide your right leg up, switch sides. Your right knee comes to chest, your left leg goes long. You might feel a real difference, right? One side to the other side from a tightness standpoint. Where do we carry our tension? Where do we carry the imbalances in our body? Just breathe. Deep breath. Couple more. And then slide your left foot to the floor. Press your right foot back to the floor. Lift your hips enough just to take that block out and set your block aside. Grab your strap one last time. You're going to look for that loop. Again, and this is a little tricky, so just hang in there with me. Place the loop, one part of the loop around your right foot, and then keep some tension on that strap. Walk your left leg through and bend your left knee. So start to straighten your right leg, and it might be easier to figure out here. As you straighten your right leg to the floor, the loop is around your left hip crease, okay? So your knee is bent. And then I want you to tighten your strap so that as your left knee, and you might even have to bend your right knee to tighten and then straighten, so that your left knee is up at your chest. You've got a pretty deep stretch here. Your hands can go behind your knee. And as you bring your knee, your left knee closer to chest with that strap around the hip crease, your right foot is pressing away. Be mindful if this feels really diggy, like it's hurting your inner thigh, then maybe you just don't go as tight, and that's okay. Shoulders, upper body are relaxed. Maybe you straighten your left leg up to the ceiling, maybe not. Keep pressing into your left, into your strap, into your foot. Deep breath. So releasing the hips, right? Just we're creating space, releasing those hips. Bend your left knee, bend your right, switch the strap so it's on your left foot and on your right hip crease. Straighten your left leg toward the floor, bring your right knee toward your chest. Again, it might be the same length. It might have to be adjusted looser or tighter. Take a really deep breath. Maybe straighten the right foot up to the ceiling. Keep the pressure on your left leg. This stretch has been coming up a lot in the yoga articles as a way to create space in the hips and release low back issues. So if it really bothers you and you want to try this again later, since I didn't cue it or think of it, maybe a washcloth or something around the strap will ease the dig into the thigh. And bend your knee. Release both legs. Release your strap. Bring both knees to your chest. Both legs up to the ceiling. Use your hands to support it. Point your toes. Flex your feet. Lower your right leg to the floor. And lower your left leg to the floor. Take those feet wide on your mat, right? When we do that, the legs will externally rotate, the hips will soften and relax. Your arms can be in whatever position feels good for you. And let's find Shavasana. And as we start to deepen in Shavasana a little bit, I want you to come back to the miracle of this body. The number of breaths that you take every day, the number of times that your heart beats, the way the brain communicates with the nervous system, which communicates with the muscles to walk. Just all of it is amazing. So we smile at our bodies. We smile at our worries, our judgments. We just smile. We feel our bodies settling in, settling down. Allow the thoughts that come into your mind naturally to just float through. The challenge is to not hold on to them, to let them be what they are, nothing more. If you notice tension coming into your body or your breath shortening, no doubt you are thinking about something. So let that go. see if you can go a little softer still. Take these few moments to allow your practice to be incorporated into the very cells of your body. That is part of Shavasana. And knowing that you can stay in Shavasana for as long as you like. Those of you who are ready, start to wiggle your toes and your fingers. Allow a smile to come across your face. Allow that smile to feed your body. Drawing the knees to your chest, rock side to side. Allow the knees to roll to one side or the other. And very, very slowly press all the way up to your seated pose.